Would you like to know the proper way to record everything listed on your paycheck? Well, this video will show the real way to deal with salary and wages when you're doing QuickBooks for home finance. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Salary, or wages, is money you earn from a job where you qualify as an employee, not an independent contractor. The paying company must withhold several taxes and possibly other withholdings from your gross pay. What you physically receive in your job's paycheck, that amount is called net pay. Your monthly financial statements are not showing the whole picture if you only record the net pay and do not put into QuickBooks the gross pay amount that you actually earned and each withholding that you pay as an expense. The proper way to do that is to read from the pay stub of the paycheck. So everything you need is in a typical pay stub. The salary will be part of your gross pay, and these are the expenses that you should have listed one by one on your income statement profit and loss. And the net pay is the physical amount of money that you deposit to the bank. And you have to record the net pay being deposited in order to match your bank records and be able to do bank reconciliation. You have to add all the income and expense accounts listed here so that you can record from your pay stub each time you get a check from your job. So in our example, we will have five accounts that we have to add to the chart of accounts. Federal income tax as an expense, state income tax as an expense, Social Security, Medicare, and even health insurance will all be listed as expenses, and they'll all be deducted from salary income, and salary income will be the income account. In our example, we will add five of these expense deductions from salary. Federal income tax as an expense, state income tax as an expense, Social Security and Medicare, both tax expense, and health insurance expense. And all of these are deducted from salary income, which we also have to add to the chart of accounts. So let's go ahead and add these six accounts now. We click Accounting, Chart of Accounts, and first we'll click New, and the first one will be Income, and the detail type can be Other Primary Income. With the cap locks on, type in salary income and then type and click save and new. Now the rest will be expenses, and the detail type very rarely makes a difference. In this case, we could choose payroll wage expense, which is fine, but it doesn't really matter. It won't affect anything. And the first one will be federal income tax. Save and new. Notice it conveniently keeps the account type and detail type, so you just have to change the name. State income tax, save and new. What's next? Social Security. Save and new. Medicare. Save and new. And health insurance deduction. For the last one, you can click Save and Close, and you can observe that these expenses and the income for salary have been added to your chart of accounts. Now, let's do the example. Let's imagine Joe became a salaried worker during the month of September, and he gets his check once a month, and he will deposit that check every month to Chase Bank. So let's imagine on October 15th, he got his monthly paycheck. The numbers were as follows. The gross pay was $2,000. The federal tax withheld was $300. The state tax withheld was $100. Social Security, $124. And Medicare, $29. And don't forget our last deduction, healthcare, $67. Now, we cannot record this in the register because there aren't enough fields on each line of the register to record all of these deductions in one transaction. Instead, you have to use the alternative windows that were shown earlier. Click New, then go over to Bank Deposit. Then, of course, you have to put the date as October 15th of 2021. Make sure the money is being deposited into Chase Bank. Now, when it comes to a W-2, you don't need the name of the person or the job for each check because you know what it is. But the first account will be the income account, salary income, and that will be the gross amount listed on the check that we earned, $2,000. We push the tab key to save the field. Then below salary income, we click for the next line. And the next line will be federal income tax withheld, $300. So we type in FE to filter to find the account that we just put federal income tax. And on the line of federal income tax, we put a minus 300 because it is decreasing the amount of the deposit by the amount of tax withheld. Now, state tax, 100, the same thing. Click under the line, STA, to filter it so we find the account we put in. And on the same line of state tax, in the amount field, minus 100. Push tab, and that lowers the deposit. What's next? Social Security, 124. So on the next line, click SOC. Here's Social Security expense. Put it on the same row, minus 124. What's next? Medicare, 29. Click under here, Medicare, the expense that we just added, minus $29, and the last deduction from the check, healthcare, $67. So we click here, health insurance deduction, and we put it as a minus $67, push tab. Now, if we scroll to the bottom, we see that the net pay that was deposited into Chase Bank on October 15th was $1,380. We earned $2,000, but we had all these deductions. Now we can click Save and Close, and then when we click Reports, Profit and Loss, you can see that the salary income is now included in the income section of the profit and loss, and all of the different taxes withheld show up for the first time in the expense section of the profit and loss, lowering the normal operating income. Let's do his second paycheck together just for practice. On November 15th, he got his monthly paycheck for the next month. And you'll notice the numbers are exactly the same as they usually will be when it comes to salaried workers and consecutive checks. Not always, but in this example, yes. So let's do November 15th check. We click New, Bank Deposit. We go forward to November 15. Make sure you're depositing to Chase Bank. The first account is the salary income account, and that goes in as a positive number. Then federal income tax expense goes in as a negative number. State, by the way, if I'm going too fast, please just pause the video to catch up. I'm using the tab key to move the cursor very fast across the row. State income tax withheld was minus 100. Social Security tax withheld was minus 124. Medicare tax withheld, just push the tab key and the cursor will move, minus 29, because that was what was withheld. And the health insurance deduction, push tab, I'm going very fast, but you can pause. The health insurance deduction was 67, minus $67 from the check. So you will notice if the gross pay and the taxes are the same as the previous check, then the net pay should also be the same as the previous check. And again, you can pause the video if I put in the numbers too quickly. But when you click Save and Close, your profit and loss now reflects the accumulated totals of both months' paycheck. Salary income is $4,000. Federal income tax went up to $600. If I double-click, you can see both the October and November paychecks contributed to his federal tax expense accumulating to $600. So you can see each month how the numbers accumulate. You can try the December paycheck on your own. The December paycheck has the exact same numbers as the two prior paychecks. I'm going to pause the video and put this in myself and show you the final accumulated totals and see if yours are the same as mine. Now here we are back at the profit and loss after recording the December 15th check. Notice salary income is $6,000, federal income tax is now $900, health insurance is $201, Medicare $87, Social Security $372, state tax $300, and Medicare $87. So these are the proper numbers from the proper way that you would record a salary paycheck for each pay period in your home finance records.